Hello everyone. Hopefully all of you are fine at your place. In today's class, we are going to discuss about the day-to-day's problem, and that is focused on motion in a straight line. So we try to see a lot of phenomena around us. We try to understand the basic day-to-day's problem, what actually the motion is, how it comes into play when we are going to the school. So suppose we are using the auto or some other vehicle, so mother drop at that time to the bus stop, and we are sitting in a bus and bus is moving, mother say hello, hi, and in this way the daily routine is going on. When in the after 6 or 7 hours, when the school is over, again we came back from the school, mother picked us from the same place, and again the vehicle moved from that place. So in this particular example, this is a day-to-day's problem, day-to-day's situation. According to my mother, I was sitting in a bus, so bus is in motion, and according to mother, I am also in motion. According to me, the mother is at that place, so she is at rest, and as bus is moving, the system is moving, and my friends are sitting inside the bus. So with respect to my friend Valia, I am at rest. So both Narendra and Bali are sitting in a bus, and when we study the motion with respect to the things outside, our day-to-day's experience, that bus is moving in the forward direction and the trees are moving in the backward direction. So again a curiosity arises, a lot of excitement comes into the mind, that when the bus or we are moving in a particular direction, why the trees are moving in opposite direction. So all as a nutshell, as a whole, this chapter is totally focused on the real time situation. Even physics is such a subject which is connected with a lot of day-to-day's problem. So in motion in a straight line, it is not a straight line, but this is the particular dimensions in which we are going to study. So let us try to understand some of the phenomena which is connected with this one. You can see from the diagram, the red color car and the road is also marked here, and you can see this is a particular we can say the type of the motion in a straight line. The vehicle which is moving in a road is a good example for the straight line. So a car is moving, you can see the motion of the car. So this is a motion in a straight line. Because we are having a different dimension. Suppose I as a teacher start writing on the blackboard, so it has a two dimensions. You can in day-to-day's life also, you have observed that when you are sitting in a classroom, nowadays it's a pandemic, you are not in the school situation, but we are familiar with these terms, that it has a length and breadth. Suppose something is fly in the air, so that is having all the three dimensions. Even the room where we are sitting, the corner, you can see the one side, the length, breadth and the height. So three dimension, how we can understand this one. So motion in a straight line has a very, very important application in our daily situations. We are experiencing so many examples where we can explain this. But in order to understand this in detail, we must understand the very, very small phenomena in the physics. Suppose particle. Particle kise kehte hain. Particle, most of the times we put a dot and we said this is the particle in which object which has negligible dimensions. So what is the meaning of the negligible dimensions? Means the length, breadth and height is not to be marked. It is approximately equal to zero, not equal to zero. So it has a negligible dimensions. So that particular point we are इंडिकेटिंग वी आर एक्सप्लेनिंग दिस वन विद ए पार्टिकल. रिजिड बॉडी के बारे में जब हम बात करते हैं, इट इज़ द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स एंड वेन एन एक्सटर्नल फोर्स इज अप्लाइड देर विल बी नो चेंज इन इट्स डायमेंशन. ह्यूमन बॉडी ले लीजिए, जस्ट यू टेक योर ओन बॉडी एंड आवर बॉडी स्टार्ट बेंडिंग हेयर और देयर. यू कैन सी it is made up of in the combination of the particles, very very small particles, and an external force we are apply from any of the way, but there is no change in the dimensions. Even when we shake the branches of the tree, so what happened at that time? That is a rigid body. We start shaking, but after that again there is no change in the dimension. So rigid body is the combination of the particle and this the external force that comes into play. Let us we take this example. This is a suppose this is my picture. My student is there. Are you a rigid body or are you a particle? So obviously it's a very very important question. It's related with our situation that we are a particle or a rigid body, a question sparking in the mind, and definitely occurs it in our mind. That is, you can see when it has a finite distance that remain same particle are considered to be a rigid as the relative distance is less and you consider to be a body. So this is somehow how we relate the terms, how we understand the terms. As relative distance is very less, relative indicates here something has to be changed. Suppose I am right now, I am sitting at one place and something is moving. So according to me, the position of the object changes, the vehicle is moving. So we consider it as a part of the relative motion. So here this is very important part to understand the what actually the body is. This is a aeroplane flying in the sky. You can see beautifully this how it is flying in the sky, and globally it is moving anywhere from one place to the another. So according to the situation it changes its position, and as the relative distance between the particular place, a person or a student, those who is studying in Australia and flight is moving from India, the relative distance is a large and the person appear as a particle. So the same object changes its configuration, changes its dimensions. If the distance is less, then it is a body, and if the distance is very very large, it appears to be a particle. So this is something very very fundamental terms that clicks in our mind to understand the basic phenomena. That is particle and the rigid bodies are relative terms. We cannot define or we cannot specific or we cannot stick to the one particular point that it is a body, then it is a body. The same body becomes a particle when the distances are very very large. So let us try to switch over to the problem, that is the rest and motion. Which object we call it as rest? Which object we call is in motion? So rest means when the particle is at one position. Suppose my physics copy is on the table, it remains on that particular place till we apply a force, we take it to do some work. For example, you can see in the picture the television, it has a fixed value. It has a fixed value means the place where we have installed this, so it remain at that particular. We are not changing it regular basis. Now today in the drawing room, tomorrow in the kitchen, next in the lobby. So it is at the rest position. Has a fan. Fan start rotating. Does it in the rest position? You must be clear about the. There is no confusion in any of the concept. The fan at rest. Although the motor start rotating, but the complete system is at rest. So this is an important term. So how we come to the basic concept of this? If a body does not change its position with respect to the surrounding, then the body is said to be at rest. Then the body is said to be at rest. This is very, very important when the object does not change its position with respect to the surrounding. So we must understand the rest and the position term. So we try to understand this one in a detail. So what actually the motion is? Now when the fan start moving blades of the fan, they are in motion. All the system is in rest. So moving, when we are sitting in a vehicle, the vehicle is moving. So vehicle is in motion. Although the person with respect to one another, they are at rest. They are at rest. So this is a the example. These example make a clarity about the concept, which type of the object we call at rest, which type of the object we call in motion. So changing the position with respect to the time, we call it as motion. So let us we continue. You can hear the natural sound from the outside, how the words are hitting the window of my room. I'm in Himachal, and now in this time we are spending in vacations at my village. So the words, the natural things, sometimes in the classes we will also explore the nature. So let us we continue. Are the passenger in the bus at rest or in motion? So it depends upon the situation. Again a statement give a lot of clarity about the fundamentals. That is, everyone, those who are standing, suppose at the in the bus, is at, if it is inside the system, so one another, they are in the rest. And if now according to this situation, you can see the vehicle is moving. So according to the situation, the person, those who are standing at the bus stop, they are at the rest position, and according to them the bus is moving. According to the persons, those who are sitting inside the bus, the system is moving, and objects are at the rest position. Even they have observed to move in the backward directions. So this is something about the rest and the motion, which make a clarity of the concept. So passenger in the bus are at rest relative to each other. So this is the conclusion. So passenger with respect to, because the system is moving, you can see from the tire rotation, you can see in this particular diagram, in particular GIF, you can see the vehicle is moving, system is moving, but passengers are rest to one another. So passenger in the bus are in motion relative to the people at bus stop. That is more important, because according to them, the bus came and it moved. Suppose my hand is moving in this way, so I am at rest, and the passenger, those who are sitting in the bus, they are in motion. So passenger in the bus are in motion relative to the people, those who are at the bus stop. So this is I think this today's class make a clarity about the rest and the motion, what actually it is. So a body is said to be at rest when there is no change of the position with respect to the time. So in order to define the motion, motion is the change of the position with respect to time. So it makes a clarity of the topic when we try to connect with the actual concept of the physics. So that is the kinematics, which deals with the study of the motion. It is the special branch of the mechanics where we study of motions of the object without knowing the cause. What is moving? Moving. That is another reason why it is moving. Why it stop? Why it changes its direction? That is another concept. But without knowing the cause, we call it as kinematics. And once a system of coordinates axis with respect to which an event can describe is called the frame of reference. So from where you are coordinate, where you are studying all these concepts, that will give you the concept of frame of reference. Although the rest and motions are relative terms, motion of the object is always with respect to some frame of reference, that is the point of observation from where you are going to start. So in this particular, the object, those who are standing at the bus stand, is in a one particular frame of reference. And second, when the vehicle is moving along this one, so according to this frame of reference, they are in motion. So that is another frame of reference. So a system in another frame of reference, and here the one system which is another frame of reference, one frame of reference is studying the another one, and according to them, they explain the concept of the relative and motion. So let us see how the state of motion and rest are related. Rest and motion are relative terms. They are not absolute. A body can be at rest or in motion with respect to the frame of reference. For example, I told you I'm sitting with my friend Valia in a bus. So with respect to Valia, I am in the rest. And with respect to my mother, who is standing outside, who is only dropped me at the bus stop, according to her, I am in the motion. So it's a body can be rest. According to Baliaji, I am at rest. According to my mother, I am in motion. So that is another frame of reference, and I am in a bus, so this is another frame of reference. So that is the concept of the rest and motion with respect to the frame of reference. There is no frame of reference which is perfectly at rest. A man in a moving train is at rest with respect to co-passenger, but he is in motion with respect to the man outside the train. I have given you a real time example of myself and my friend Valia. So let us be try to have a reflection on today's class, what we have discussed till now. A particle or an object having negligible, it has a negligible units, dimensions, magnitude, and directions. Obviously, particle of an object having units to nahi hai, dimensions is the correct option. Okay. A rigid body is a combination of particles. When external force applied, there will be no change in its magnitude, dimensions, magnitude and direction, and the direction alone. So rigid body, it is again, there is no change of its dimensions. So this is the another question. Rest and motions are absolute terms, not absolute terms, relative terms, both B and C, not absolute and relative. So this is the correct option. They are not absolute and they are relative terms. So thank you very much for today class. We will continue with the rest of the topics in the upcoming classes. It will help for all the students, those who are in 8th onward class, maybe in class 9th, in class 10, class 11. And this motion is in general concept, also help to understand the phenomena even from the lower classes also. We will continue with some more sessions. Till then, thank you. Goodbye.